know what else is going to see a billion views tonight?
The eclipse.
The eclipse. You're going to be able to see it everywhere. Check this out. And we've got perfect viewing conditions for it. So if you are a night owl like yours truly, head outside starting around midnight. And that's when we're going to start seeing the eclipse begin. And it's going to last for a very long time, over 6 hours. In fact, the longest lunar eclipse that we have seen in 580 years. And we will see that moon covered there in that blood red color for about 97% coverage. So it's going to be quite the viewing out there. Again, clear and cold. Temperatures generally ranging between freezing and about 40 degrees, depending on what time it is you head outdoors. Speaking of outdoors, let's talk about the dog walking forecast. Temperatures getting cold tonight pretty quick. We're down to 51 by 7. 49 at 8 o'clock and 47 degrees by 9. By 10, if you're still walking the dog, I don't know what to tell you. All right, taking a look here. Freeze warnings. Nobody should be out after that at that late, okay? Freeze warnings here across North Texas. It is going to be, again, a cold night. This is the first freeze warning of the season. It does encompass all of North Texas, clear down to Navarro County. Those of you watching in Corsicana will also want to bring in that tender vegetation. Temperatures right now pretty much similar everywhere you look, 58 to 60 degrees, so a cool afternoon with that northerly wind coming in between 10 and about 15 miles per hour. The future track, temperatures once again getting pretty cold pretty quick. We're down to 48 in Dallas by 10 o'clock. 46 degrees there, 48, 46, 41, 41 there in Sherman, just about everywhere you look, holding in the low to mid 40s by 10 o'clock. And then 7 o'clock tomorrow morning, McKinney coming in at 32 degrees, Denton at 33. So take your pick. No matter where you are, we are going to be flirting with those low to mid 30s. So if we don't quite get to freezing here in the Metroplex, it will be close in our outlying areas. So again, one of those nights, you'll want to go ahead and bring in that tender vegetation. As we head into tomorrow afternoon, temperatures once again warming up into those low 60s, very much like what we saw for today. Satellite and radar, cloudy from Houston down to Corpus Christi. A few showers there to the south of San Antonio, but here locally, just another stunning day across the Metroplex. Nationwide, not much going on, but I want you to point this out. Look at, there's the cold front right there. I mean, you can see it moving right through the heart of the country, pushing into the southeast, bringing with it a much drier and cooler air mass, and that's going to be with us, it looks like, for the next day or so. All right, let's talk about some Thanksgiving travel. This takes us into next Wednesday, pretty much looking okay nationwide. A little cool up there in the northern tier of states, warmer across the state of Texas. Now, for Thanksgiving Day itself, yeah, we're talking about rain and possibly a lot of it developing here across the state of Texas. So this is a forecast that's going to continue to be in flux, something you're going to want to watch pretty carefully. We do have rain chances pretty high already as we head into Thanksgiving Day. Future track, again, not much to show you here except for our winds turning from the east and then eventually to the southeast, and that's going to help our temperatures begin to warm on up into the 70s as we head into the next couple of days. So speaking of the next couple of days, 62 tomorrow, 73 on Saturday. Our next front rolls through on Sunday. And again, guys, we're watching that Thanksgiving Day forecast pretty carefully. Right now, it's looking wet and chilly.